There's a number of things that can contribute to the persistence of pain. One can be a persistent input. So if there's a damaged nerve or something like that that ends up firing off just spontaneous signals that go up the pathways up to the brain, that can be one reason. Response of our whole body can be influenced by our perception of threat or our perception of danger. So if our brains think that there's a creditable evidence of danger to us, we'll experience those inputs as painful. If our brains perceive that those inputs are of no threat, it can significantly dampen those inputs. All of our pain is described in terms of damage, because that's what pain is meant to protect us from, is damage. And pain is unpleasant so that we try to remove ourselves from potential harm. So we might look, from a biological point of view, it can have effects of blood pressure, heart rate, gastrointestinal changes, sleep changes, so on and so forth. From a, social point of view, it can really interfere with, people's family life, their earning capacity, the way that they interact with people. From a psychological point of view, it can be distressing. It can lead to anxiety and depression, or there's a complex interplay between anxiety, depression, and other psychological and psychiatric issues that they just feed off each other. So we try to do this with a combination of education, optimization of medications, appropriate pain interventions, and physical and psychological reconditioning. So a lot of our medications and procedures are created to provide a window of opportunity for psychological and physical rehabilitation.
Care to Share, brought to you by Buderim Private Hospital, because your health matters.